we get together. And so it's always an honor for me as director of the center to host parties where best people can come together and enjoy each other. We now will have remarks from a good friend, a great supporter of the center, Melinda Kaiser. But before I turn the remarks over to her, I'd like to share that, you know, what you give to the center, you give to the Carolina Indian Circle, you give to the Carolina Indian Circle's banquet and their powwows, you give to First Nation Graduate Circle's Native Leader Symposium. When you make a gift to the center, you give to the annual Native Nation Rebuilding Forum, the Big Daniel Hitchcock Award, you give to the Michael Green Lecture on American Indian Studies, and the Cherokee Coffee Hour, and so much more. Your gift to the center goes a long way. I'm grateful for your support. Our next speaker is, as I said, Melinda Kaiser. She's a dedicated member of our advisory board for the center. She's also chair of the Alumni Committee on Racial and Ethnic Diversity, chair of their American Indian Subcommittee. She supports our efforts 100% driving from Charlotte frequently to attend day-long, half-day, or two-hour meetings. We're very grateful for her time and her dedication to her talents and of her treasures. So I'd like to present Melinda Kaiser. Taught agriculture and animal husbandry for the Veterans Administration.
as you can tell, I'm really passionate about education. And it is important for me to give back by helping American Indian students achieve a college education. Becoming engaged with AIC and Amy and her team has enabled me to become active with my tribe and make a positive impact. And that's something huge because they're all living at home and I live in Charlotte. Previously, I was a donor for the Choctaw Scholarship Advisory Program, but when I became more involved in the university by joining the AIC Advisory Board and ACRID, the Alumni Committee for Racial and Ethnic Diversity, I decided that I wanted to introduce my contacts at the Choctaw Nation to UNC and just see what happened. 3 years ago, with Amy's help and AIC and several other people, we had two members from the Choctaw Scholarship Advisory Program visit our campus. They learned about admissions and scholarship programs and said they were interested in bringing some Choctaw high school students to visit UNC. The following year, we had two of their high school students visit from Oklahoma and also two adult chaperones. And the chaperones, one ran the STAR program, which is the Success Through Academic Recognition program, and they used that to motivate Choctaw students in grades K through 12 to be successful in school and make education a priority. We can all learn from different tribes, and I just think it has really cool programs. The other adult is a member of the Chada Foundation, an organization that's responsible for Choctaw scholarships. But, you know, as more adults in the education part of the Choctaw Nation learned about UNC, you know, we have a great reputation, and it was really good. I also had the opportunity to represent UNC at the Choctaw College Connect event on Grant, Oklahoma. And Professor Valerie Lambert is going to attend with her daughter in November. But when I went, Chelsea Colander, an AIC ambassador, who's also Choctaw, she came with me. We had a great time. It was my first trip to Grant, Oklahoma. So that was really fun. And we came back with contact information from over 20 Choctaw high school students. So that was really cool. This year, I had the opportunity to work with my tribe on the Carolina Horizons program. And maybe you're aware, I hope you are, but Carolina Horizons is a summer program that makes college more accessible to American Indian students and families. Students experience campus life by living in a dorm and even in a dining hall, and they learn about the college application process and receive tips on writing college essays and so much more. But it's just phenomenal. I work with the Choctaw Tribe to get them to sponsor student travel and help them get students to apply for the program. But still, even if something is free, if you grow up in Indian country in Oklahoma, it's kind of some people haven't been on the plane and they're going to come here for a program. So anyway, they contacted every Choctaw high school student in their 12 and a half county jurisdiction by both email and mail. Four Choctaw students were selected by the Carolina Horizon Selection Committee. The Choctaw Director of College Retention, Lauren Rowland, also attended with two of her team members. The adults learned about our program and they're going to take that back and use it in some of their college programs in Oklahoma. So they're really far-reaching effects from AIC. Becoming engaged with the American Indian Center has been a rewarding experience for me. If you've given money to AIC in the past, I thank you. If you were thinking about giving money to the university sometime in the future, I hope that you will consider making a donation to the American Indian Center. Every person in this room has special talents. I just talked to you, and I'm always so inspired just being on a couple of boards, but coming to these events, they're all so special. And I encourage you to use your talents to work with the American Indian Center to help improve American Indian education opportunities. And I do hope that you will also help to bring students from your tribe to UNC.
Last thoughts.
has stood up before us. What our seventh generation will have is a consequence of our actions today. This is a quote from what Ramon will do. I hope that you'll join me in this journey going forward. Join me as we prepare for future generations that will come through Carolina, Native and non-Native alike, will benefit from the efforts of the American people. This is those who came before us, prepared for us today. I ask you to join me in preparing for those tomorrow. We have a goal that we just announced at our advisory board meeting earlier today to raise $200,000 over this next year, and that is a stretch goal for the American Indian Center. But folks, we haven't asked before, and now that they're asking, I know the goal is possible. So I invite you to join me in encouraging your friend and your colleagues to give to the American Indian Center, not just to benefit the staff, the wonderful staff that we are working with itself, not just to benefit the students on campus, not just to benefit the provost and the chancellor and our faculty, but all of us on this campus and off of this campus as well, all of the country can benefit from the support given to the center. So please continue to make a gift and giving a gift to the past. We're very thankful for your support. Many of you give, and many support us in your time as well and your talents, and that we are also very I want to say that every time we host an event, it's like bringing family together. I'm fortunate that my husband frequently joins me and is here today. My mother drove from Fayetteville to come and join us today. And so many of you I consider family after having been in UNC Chapel now for 4 years. So to all my family, I say thank you. I say continue to enjoy and safe travels.